Welcome to Wines That Make Me Thirsty, and hey ho, let's go. 2010 Barossa Shiraz, this is a no-brainer. Such a wonderful year after the horrors of 09 and sandwiched in or against 11. These 2010s, grab and get them. Get a lot of them, because it's not going to be the same. We're going to have to wait a little bit. 2012 will do the same thing, but you're going to have to wait for this style of red wine. Peter Jorgensen makes a habit of producing very soft, silky, mouth-filling flavored wines, and the Barossa does that really well. As Pete says, you get 8 out of 10 good vintages in the Barossa, and that's why he's there. So it's quite a got a savory edge to it. There's leather, there's black licorice, there's soya, Vegemite-y type aromas. It's not just blackberry jam leaping out of the glass. Mind you, it could be. It's 14.8%. And it's got coconut character as well. There's a peeling with the oak. This is a fresh black pepper edged plum and blackberry flavored wine with enough tannin to be worth aging for a couple of years. It's got some real firmness on the finish. So we've got a full bodied, velvety soft, firm finishing dry red style, again with that beautiful Barossa fruit flavor, that's silk that the good Barossa has. It's a generous, round, warm, friendly wine. You won't be disappointed, I don't believe, if you're looking for that everyday drinking style of Shiraz. It's Wines That Make Me Thirsty. Cheers.